Good evening. My name is Mary McLeod, and welcome to Senior Upbeat. Tonight, we're going to complete the fourth in a series of history and the present also on Hopkinton in Woodville. And so many people have enjoyed this that we're just so happy to reach this point of doing the last one and just join us. And tonight, I'd like to introduce you to Aubrey Doyle, who's going to talk to us on sports in Hopkinton, and no one can do it as good as Mr. Doyle. Mr. Doyle, how are you?
Very, very good, Mary. First sport that was introduced in Hopkinton was baseball, and that the earliest writing that I have on it was in 1913, when the West End AC played the high school.
Mm-hmm.
And the West End AC beat them 6-2. But some of the names on there were Joe McCormick and Joe Creedon and Bill Dineen. Now, Joe McCormick is the father of Paul McCormick, who taught and coached baseball here for many years. Joe Creedon has a niece who lives on Mount Auburn Street now.
Mm-hmm.
And Bill Dineen has cousins over at the lake, John Dineen and that family. And in the 1920s, they had a team, and Chick Welch coached some of the time. I think the first coach was Seamus O'Brien, who would be Jack O'Brien, the former superintendent of schools father. But in 1932, they had a very good team. They went 13-1. The only loss was the last game of the year to Ashland. And on that team, you had Ray McMillan and Bill Kenny. Those names are old Hopkinton names. Tom Brown, whose brother Walter also played baseball at Hopkinton and also founded the Celtics. And Bob Moran and Ray Danahy. And in 1936, they went 13-2, and the big guns there were Kelly Whalen and Billy Danahy and Buzz Cady. Billy and Buzz still live in town. Kelly has passed away, but he's the great uncle of Jeff Bagwell, the Houston first baseman, who's a very strong home run hitter. And then in 1944, they had the best record that Hopkinton baseball has ever had. They went 16-1.
Mm-hmm.
The only loss was to St. Mark's School from Southborough, and they lost that in 5-4 in 12 innings. And Billy McDonough was the captain of that team, and Ted Hunt, Richie McBride, and Al Cunningham were starters there. Ted Hunt is an uncle by marriage of Chris Stickney, the present high school player, or just recent graduate, and Richie McBride is related to Colin McBride. And then in 1948, and the team went 13-1 again, and Dave Whalen and Dave Cross and Arthur Lowell were the big guns there. Dave Whalen is a brother of Kelly, and Dave Cross and Arthur still live in town. Arthur lives on Hayden Row, and Dave lives on Grove Street. In 1949, Hopkinton was the East Central League champions. Now that league, of course, is gone by now, but Barney Dougherty and Paul Bowker and Joe Kenny were there. Barney's brother Paul runs Angels Hilltop Gardens. And then in 1963 was the first Hopkinton tournament team. Now these earlier teams with those records would have gone to tournaments if the rules were the same as today. But in those days, about four teams in the whole state went to the tournament, so they didn't make it. But in 1963, Ed Hayes was the coach, and they went to the tournament. And John Safstrom was a pitcher. He still works down at Tennessee Gas. The present high school football coach, Dave Hughes, was the catcher. And the present selectman, Dick Gooding, was a pitcher on that team. In 1970, they went to the tournament again. Ken Burt was coaching then. And Ralph Edwards, whose son played football this year, Peter, and plays hockey. Rick Phipps and George Paradise were on that. George lived on Church Street with his mother, Alan, his father, Alan, his mother, Rita. And in later years, 94, 97, and 99, they went to the tournament with Steve Simos as the coach. Some of the players there were Keith Lee and Dave Clark, C.J. Balker and Barry, and then Barry Haynes, and then Chris Stickney and Steve Zick this year. Now, there are plenty of other players, but those are the ones that I can think of.
I'd love to hear the names of the people from the past, and I know some of their children and grandchildren now, and
it's so nice
that it carries over, and I'm so happy that we're doing this. I think it's
now,
nice for everybody.
In the football, I have a team picture.
Mm-hmm.
That includes Donald McMillan and Thomas Caney. I don't know what year it is. Some people say it's 1905, others say it's 1910, somebody else said it was 1913. But Donald McMillan is the uncle of Ruth Kenny, Jeremy's grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
And Thomas Caney became a priest, and he was a Monsignor down in Little Rock, Arkansas, and he brought many athletes from the local area down there to play football for the Little Rock University. Now, in 1921, the first official team that I know of, high school team, was coached by Chick Welch. And on that team, Joe Bernard played. Now, Joe was a great uncle of Jeremy Kenny.
Mm-hmm.
And Joe Murphy was the first captain.
Yeah.
In 1927, they had a real good team. They played Maynard, Marlboro, Hudson, Natick, and Milford. They won some and lost some, but they had a winning record. And the players, among the players there, we had Ig Crowley, Buck Halley. Buck went on and played at BU, and Jack Danahy, who was the local barber for many, many years.
Mm-hmm.
In 1931 was the first undefeated team that Chick coached, and Ray McMillan was the captain of that team, and Bill Kenny was on it, and both of those are great uncles of Jeremy's. And Tom Brown played on that team. He was a halfback. He was later postmaster, and in fact, pretty soon they're going to name the new post office after him.
That's good. That's good.
And Dan Colella, who founded Colella's Market, was on that team.
Mm-hmm.
And John Carey, who was principal of the high school for many years, was on that team.
Mm-hmm.
In 1944, they had another very good team. They had 7 wins and 2 losses. The 2 losses were to Shrewsbury and Northbridge. They won all their other games. And Ted Hunt, Richie McBride, and Al Cunningham were part of that team. In 1947, they were undefeated. And Dave Whalen, Dave Cross, again, were on that. Bill Stickney was on that. Now, that's Chris's grandfather. George McBride, who's Colin's father, was on that team. And the last undefeated team in Hopkinton was in 1955, and Mario Moriello was the coach. Now, Jerry Cassidy was one of the players. Bill McRobert, the just retired police chief, played on that team. And Jeff McMillan, who lives on Main Street, played on that team. They were undefeated that year, and they were league champions. Now, this was the South Central League. It was before the Tri-Valley League. And they won the league in 1955, 56, 57, and 58 under three different coaches. Mario for 2 years, Vic Rimkus for one, and then Ed Leary was the coach in 1958. Joe Pine, who still lives in town, Bill Terry were on those teams, Bob Evers. Now, Tim Danahy, who's now out in Kansas, but Jack Danahy's son played on those, and Bill Hayward and Bill McMillan, who both live in town, were on those teams. The last league champion was 1963, and that was coached by Ed Hayes, and Al Harris, and Rick Small. His sister Jean works in the assessor's office,
mm-hmm.
and Bill O'Neill, whose sister, Mrs. Rimby, teaches in the third grade, so family is still here. In 1981, Hopkinton tied for the league title, tied with Holliston. Dave Hughes was coaching then. Tim Doyle played on that team. Steven Pitts and Steve Slammon. Steve Slammon is a fireman in town now. In 1993, they went to the Super Bowl with Dave Hughes and Keith Lee, Brian Pepe, Jason Flannery. I think Keith and Jason are still in town. And then last year, of course, they went 9-1, as you know, with Chris Stickney and Jeremy.
Yes. Yes.
They both have people from the past.
You people must have marvelous reunions. Do you ever get together and,
oh, yeah.
and go
yeah, every
over
10
old
years
films?
The football team. Well, there weren't many films from back then.
No, but recently, I mean, it must be nice to get together.
Oh, yeah, we do.
Good,
and,
I hope so.
Rosemary Lynch has the Steggy Prep reunions, which brings all the classes up to 56 together.
That's good.
They do that about
Wonderful.
Every 5 or 6 years. So.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
Now, hockey was the next sport. I realized that it wasn't a sport for many years, but in 1926, 27, 27, 28, 28, 29, and 29, 30, they had a team here. In 1 year, they beat Framingham and Natick. They played their games at the Ice House down at Lawrence Pond in Framingham, and at the Boston Arena. Now,
mm-hmm.
George V. Brown, whose sons were playing on these teams, was the director of the arena. He lived down in Hayden Row Street, right next to Mrs. Rimby. And Ray McMillan and Ed Curley played on some of those teams. And Amos Holt was the captain 1 year. Amos used to run the turkey farms in town. And a few days before Thanksgiving, a lot of boys would be absent from school because they were plucking turkeys.
Oh, I see.
But And Edmund Cronin was the captain of the 1930 team. Now, Edmund would was the brother of Earl Cronin on the funeral home. Mm-hmm. And then in 1996 and 97, the last few years, the team has been rejuvenated, and Jim McConey and Peter Edwards seem to be the big guns there. Now, believe it or not, girls' basketball started in Hopkinton before boys' basketball.
Oh, really?
1932 was the first team. Mm-hmm. Ruth Harrell was the captain. She still lives right on Main Street. And Maude McEwen was the coach. And then the next few years, Anna Dalton was the coach. And in 1935, Miss Harris came to coach, and she coached right through until 1958. And her first undefeated team was 1937, where Ruth McMillan and Mary McDonough played. Now, Mary McDonough lives on Pleasant Street. Billy Carey, who runs the taxi service, is her son. And Ruth is Jeremy's grandmother. And then she was also undefeated in 1941-42. Eleanor Pierce, who was passed away, was captain. And Jean Bowker played on that team. She's now Jean Murray down on Hayden Row. And in 1955, they were undefeated. Annie Martin, Charlotte Hazen, and Jean Dumas were on that team. Annie still lives in Woodville. Charlotte's on Hayden Row, and Jean lives down on Main Street. So they're still in town. And in 1958, they were undefeated. Jackie Irving and Carol Dodson played in that team. Now, Carol Dodson is now Carol Spengler.
Okay.
So, and in 1958-59, they were undefeated under Eva Cellularo. She took over after Miss Harris, and she had Mary Cronin on that team, and Nancy Clark played there, too. Mary is now down at the funeral home. In 1982 and 83, Dick Luzzi took him to the tournament, with Mary Margaret and Lisa Murray as his playing on that team. And then from 85 to 93, Chuck Joseph went almost every year. I think he went all of those years, but he may have missed once. And Susie Donovan and Michelle Fredette were on that first one, and then Jessica Murphy and Stacy Dakey and Sonny Pearson were big guns through there. Then in 1994, they were the Division IV state champions. Rick Martin only coached 1 year, but he was the champion there. And Kerry Chatton and Sarah Murphy were on that team. And then in 97, 98, and 99, Dick Bliss took him to the tournament. And in 98, he won the Division IV state championship again. He had Terry Phipps and Jamie Keeler and Amanda Coffin playing for him. And the girls started in 32, and the boys started the next year in 1933. And the principal at that time was Bob Fox, and he was also the basketball coach. Ray McMillan played on that team. In 1943-44, they had the best record until the 1980s, and that was coached by Frank Moriarty. They were 13-5, and Mike McBride and Bobby Lavoie were on that team. In 1949 and 50, the team tied for the East Central League title and went to the tournament. Frank was the coach, Don Melvin and Joe Kenny played on that team. And the next time they went to the tournament was in 1981 and 82 with Dick Bliss coaching. He had Brian Thomas and Rick Corbett and a few others on that. So, and then you kept going in 86 and 87. They were the South Sectional champions. Dick Bliss coached. He had Chuck Mullen and Liam Kenny as his big guns then. Then in 97 and 98, Dave Aldridge took him to the tournament with C.J. Balker and Keith Benson. And last year, they won for the first time, the Tri-Valley League Championship with Tony Cardone and Steve Zick and Chris Kimball.
Very good. Very good. Wow, you have done your homework, Barbara. You really have. And I think what we'll do is take a little break,
okay,
and then we will come back. Okay?
All right with me.
Very good. So we're cut, right?
We're cut.
We're cut.
Yeah. if you want to come in with any questions or anything anytime, go ahead, because I'm just more or less stating the fact.
No, I think I don't want to interrupt. Well, welcome back. And let's continue on.
Well, the next sport was girls' softball. And Ms. Harris started that in 1943. And it was amazing. They went from 1943 to 1948 and never lost a game.
Mm-hmm.
Not many teams or coaches have done that. Among her players were Jean Balker, Margaret Nugent, who was down at the housing, Marilyn Varnum, Pat Doyle, Jean McSweeney. Jean still lives on Mount Auburn Street. In 1955, they were undefeated again under Ms. Harris. And Annie Martin and Jackie Irving were the big guns then.
Mm-hmm.
Then from the late 50s until 1983, when Dick Luzzi took over, Ms. Harris's teams, of course, couldn't go to tournaments because they didn't have them then, but it was in 1983 that Dick took them to the tournament, and he won 83, 84, and 85, and then in 86, they were South sectional champions, and he had Susie Donovan, Michelle Fredette, and Patty Pine on those teams. Michelle was the pitcher, that's Hank's daughter. And then again in 94, Laurie Whalen took him to the tournament. In 95, they went to the tournament. She was coaching. She had Mary Lauzon pitching, and Crystal Villa was her catcher. And then in 96, 97, and 98, Brian King, they went to the tournament each year. Some of those players were Sarah McIntyre, Terry Phipps. Now, Terry's grandmother was Mary McDonough, who played for Ms. Harris, and Bridget McManus. And then in 1999, Dave Telgren was the coach, and they went to the tournament, and Aaron McIlvain and Missy McDonald were his big guns. Now, field hockey was another sport that was interrupted. In 1950, 51, and 52, Ms. Harris had a team, and they played. Then they dropped the sport until Sue Beaver started again in 1971.
Great. Mm-hmm.
Janet Nordmark, she and her husband owned the Sticky Wicket when that was going
yes.
big guns.
Oh, yes.
And Doris Nelson, who's Cookie's wife, played on those teams.
Mm-hmm.
And then Sue started the team in 1971, and Dale Clawler, Ed Clawler's, was on that. Becky Love from the Love family, Colleen Doyle, Sue Hayward, who lives on Pleasant Street now. In 1977 was the first year they went to the tournament, and Julie Doyle and Diane Brown and Beth Stickney were on that team. And then 1982, Sue Beavers coached that team. In 1982, she coached the league championship team, and they went to the tournament. And Mary Marquardt and Joanne Hayward were her big guns. Then in 1984 and 85, Lisa Doyle was coaching them. They went to the tournament. In 84 and 85, they were league champions and went to the tournament. And that's the Michelle Fredette, Susie Donovan, Kathy Murphy group. They went to all of the tournaments. And then 1987 and 98, Jessica Murphy took over. She's been coaching, and she took them to the tournament those 2 years, and her big gun was Missy McDonald, who I guess will be back next year. Now, the next sport was golf, which started when the Saddle Hill Country Club opened. In the original charter, I was told, I've never seen it, that it said that Hopkins High School could play golf there as long as it was in existence. Whether that's still in there or not, I don't know.
I hope it is.
But we've had three coaches, Frank mm-hmm. Moriarty, Clayton Smith, and Dick Bliss. And the leading players have been Jeff DeVincentis, who is now a golf pro down at Hilton Head in South Carolina. Chuck Mullen, who works over at the Marlboro Country Club, and Roger Adams, who works up here at Saddle Hill.
Mm-hmm.
Now, they've gone to the tournament many, many years, and I don't think anybody has won the state championship from Hopkins, but some of these players have been in the running. Boys tennis was played from 1965 to 1982, and there was very little interest, and it was very difficult to get a coach. In fact, 1983, we tried to get a coach, and there was nobody that was available, so the sport was dropped. But then in 1997, it was reintroduced, and they now have a boys' tennis team.
And now it's very popular, yeah. Tennis.
And girls' tennis has started in 1970. They had many coaches, Sue Beavers and Joe Barnes among them. Dick Bliss was another one. And Nancy Clark now coaches it. Now the best tennis player, girls tennis player that I know of in Hopkins was Stacy Dakey. She played number one from grade 7 to grade 12.
Wow.
So she was pretty good. Boys soccer started on the varsity level in 1976. Ken Burt was the coach. He coached right up until 1990, until he retired. Among his stalwarts were Steve Scalata, who lives over on Oakhurst Road, mm-hmm. Peter Mezzett from Western Nurseries, Adam West. Now, I see Adam West's landscaping trucks around town,
That's
so
right.
I assume he's back in town. And Mark mm-hmm. Aranzella down on Teresa Road. In 1994, Chip Del Pret took over, and he's taken them to the tournament in 1997 and 98. Steve Zick was his goalie, and I believe he was an all-star goalie for him. And the girls' soccer started in 1984, and Tom Maroney was the original coach, and Stacy Dakey played that. Tracy Jajari, whose mother is Rachel Bartlett. In 1997, they won the Tri-Valley League with Howard Cohen was the coach, and they had Jess Scoglin and Amanda Coffin as the big guns that year. And then in 1998, they went to the tournament again. Cross country is another sport that started back in the 1970s. Barry Allman was the coach, and it ran out of steam in about 1975. And then when Mike Scanlon came, he revived it in the 1980s. He had girls and boys together, and he also had a boys' team and a girls' team. Among a couple of his good runners were Jen Godin and Rachel Donahue. Jen lives down in Wood Hollow, and Rachel, I don't think, is in town anymore. Now, girls' track started in the 1980s with Mike. First they had winter, and then winter and spring,
mm-hmm.
and they've done very well. Jen Britz went to South Carolina and took part in track down there. Heather Dye was another outstanding one. He's got Christine Muscala and Jess Titus now, who are state champions, so
mm-hmm.
he's been very successful with the program. The boys' track started in 1986. The first team they just had to learn what to do on the track. Brendan Doyle was on that. Keith Lee was one of the stalwarts in the later years, and the Coffin twins have done very well in the last few years. And the 1999, they won their first title. I believe they have a new coach now, but I'm not mm-hmm. sure who that is. And swimming is now a sport in the school. That started in 1996. And it's a mixed gender team. And of course, they have all their meets away. Although I guess they have some at Keefe Tech, but mm-hmm. we have no pool, so they can't have anything here.
Can we have our new high school?
Well, we won't have a pool there, will we?
Well, maybe.
Well, I didn't see it in the plans, but that could
okay.
be. And the last sport that I know about is girls volleyball. And they've improved each year. It's a fall sport for the girls, and it's a good sport. But for some of them to get in condition for some of the winter sports. So they seem to enjoy it.
Mm-hmm.
And that is all. Now, if I've missed any sports, then.
Well, you have done a wonderful job, and I'm just so glad that we were able to complete that. You know what I miss is Little League. I remember the days of your son and my son and Jeff McRoberts, John Palmer. They
well,
were quite a crew.
It's still in existence. I've got
Isn't
grandchildren
it
in it.
Yes. I was going to ask you now. Your sons were all, your children were all involved in sports.
Oh, yeah, all the way through.
Yeah. And your grandchildren, how many grandchildren now do you have living here in town? School age.
Six. Well, one of them, Gina's not school age yet.
Right. So you're going to see another generation go through. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
That is wonderful. Out of all the sports, which one do you think has the strongest effect on Hopkinton? Probably football?
I would say that, but mm-hmm. I'm sure there'd be people that would dispute it. But that's just an opinion. I think. You go out there Thanksgiving Day, and there's always a big crowd, rain or shine.
Oh, Thanksgiving,
good record or bad record.
That's right.
So.
I grew up in Natick, and we competed with Framingham. And Natick was quite a team, too, for many, many years.
Yeah.
I don't know how they are now, you know, if they are strong.
They're good. But they lost to Framingham last year, but they usually do.
Mm-hmm.
Well.
Mm-hmm. We had Dan Bennett. Does that sound familiar to you?
Yeah, I can tell you a Dan Bennett story.
He was my history teacher, too.
He was coaching in Millis. This was before we went to Natick.
Mm-hmm.
And they had a game over here. against Hopkinton, and no officials showed up. Now, this was in 52, 53, I'm not sure which. Mm-hmm. One of the years I wasn't around. And so the coaches officiated the game. They played the game, and the coaches, and Dan and Bill Dempsey and the other coaches officiated the game.
Mm-hmm. Now, Chick Welch, how was he, what did he do in Natick? Wasn't he?
He ran the
Did he
Natick,
coach there too?
Natick Bullet. No, he never coached there. He always coached in Hopkinton.
Okay.
He coached football from 1921 to 1950, mm-hmm. and baseball the same. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he taught phys ed in the elementary school, but that was only part-time. I mean, that was, I don't know. Well, he taught all of phys ed. Because when I was in school, we would march down to the old gym in high school. We'd march down to the old gym on Friday, and Chick would have, we'd have phys ed there.
I see.
Once a week, you had it. And that was the whole group went.
Yeah, I see.
Of course, the whole group, there were 26 in my class, so.
Mm-hmm. I see.
19 in the class after me, so. But, and he had the center schoolers over there another day. But it was only like 2 or 3 days he did that. But he was the publisher, editor, whatever you want to call it, of the Natick Bulletin.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So. Well, he has a son now, Davidson Welch, right? Okay.
Davidson was the captain of his baseball team in 1938.
He's quite an artist also.
Oh, yeah. That's his big thing. Yeah, he's mm-hmm. a great artist. Mm-hmm.
And also, I think his aunt was, I knew her, of course, as Miss Welch, third grade teacher in Natick.
Oh. Yeah.
You know, so.
Oh, well, I met her at the wake, but I mean, I didn't know his Chick's sister.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Where do you see swimming going? Do you think that's going to become stronger with girls as well as boys?
The ones that are into it are really into it. They do it all year round, so it will. But I don't know how many people are that dedicated. That's the whole thing. And swimming, it's. Is you have to be very dedicated to because you've got to go somewhere to, you can't just go to your local gym.
That's right.
You have to go somewhere to swim, and then you have to go somewhere to practice, to participate, and of course a lot of them go in the AAU part of it, and they get extra time there, but it's a group of dedicated people that want to be swimmers.
Mm-hmm. I think it's important that phys ed keep going, don't you, in the school?
Oh, I do. I think that's a much needed thing. I think the students need to get out there
that's
and
right.
work out a little bit. I don't think they get enough work. The athletes, fine, they do, but the others, I think, watch too much TV or sit at the computer too much. And,
Now, the computer has made a change, that's for sure, in many areas.
Oh, that's fine, but they still need to their physical. He's giving you the signal.
Okay. Before we close, we have one more minute. What stands out with the marathon with you? You know, what year? Was there somebody special that had an effect on you who you think has contributed a lot?
The thing I remember the most is way, way back when Tarzan Brown ran. He was an Indian from Narragansett, Rhode Island.
Now, what year was this?
Oh, 1930s. He ran more than once, and they started down at Lucky Rock then.
Really?
And I just always stuck in my mind. We'd go down there and watch it. And I would usually go to Framingham and watch down on Cedar Street, and he'd go running along, and everybody seemed to be cheering for him. And, of course, Jerry and Harold Penthony ran the marathon years ago. So we had a Hopkinton flavor then.
Now, what was his name? Damar or?
Clarence Damar?
Right.
Yeah, he ran it year in and year out.
Yeah, my father-in-law used to talk about him.
Yeah, of course, Johnny Kelly ran it for years.
I remember him when I was 5 years old down in Lincoln School in Natick, standing on 135, watching John Kelly.
He won it many times and ran it many years.
Okay. I want to thank you so much for coming today, Mr. Doyle. And you're so special, and you have so much to contribute.
Pleasure to talk about sports.
Well, and thank you for watching tonight, and we will do this again. This now completes 4 in a series on Hopkinton and Woodville, and you can see it on Wednesday nights at 7 o'clock on Channel 3. So thank you so much. Good night.